And let's get to what you'll be voting on, and that, of course, is the skating. Up first, Sinead Kerr and Grant Marshall.
Right to wrist shot. Marshall scores on the rebound. 2-0.
It's the quintessential Canadian story. One Grant Marshall embraced from first lace-up.
I loved it. I said, this is what I want to do. I want to be a hockey player.
And things looked great for young Grant. At 16, he was a rising star, drafted by Ottawa of the Ontario Hockey League. 2 years later, the whole thing came to a gut-wrenching halt.
It was December 4th, 1990. My parents went to every single junior game I played, except that one game. I was playing defense. A player cross-checked from behind and went headfirst on the boards. When you can't move, but you're awake and your eyes are open, it's a scary feeling and it's a helpless feeling. It really is. You're trying so hard. Your parents driving you to the rink at 5 in the morning for practice because you have this goal to be a professional hockey player. It really comes crashing down right there.
Grant suffered 3 fractures of the neck. Surgeons used bone grafts from his hip to help repair the splintered vertebrae. He was advised to never again play the game he so loved.
It's a serious injury, yes, but if you want it bad enough, I think, you know, don't let it slow you down. Go for it.
I came back and played the exact same year that I got hurt.
Grant went to Dallas in the first round of the draft and helped the Stars win the Stanley Cup in 1999. 4 years later, he hoisted the cup again in New Jersey.
I'm very blessed to be able to have a great career and win 2 Stanley Cups and to have a major setback where not only was my career in jeopardy, but my life was in jeopardy. I have to be in that position where I want to give back. And my charity is Think First, which gives to concussions and spinal cord injuries. And the man that heads that foundation is my doctor, Charles Tatum. And hopefully we can do well and give back as much as we can. So Sinead better pick up her game.
Sinead and John Kerr of Great Britain.
Sinead Kerr of Dundee, Scotland, and her brother John are the most decorated British ice dance team since the legend of Torval and Dean. 7 national titles and appearances at both Torino and Vancouver's Winter Olympics underscore their considerable achievements.
For me, it was really special to be at that Olympic Games, look at your brother and say, wow, look at what we've been through to get here.
Family is still at the core of Sinead's life, as reflected in her charity of choice, Autism Speaks.
It's a subject really close to my heart because my youngest brother, David, is pretty severely autistic. David is the youngest of the 3 of us, and when he was about 3 years old, my parents realized that his speech hadn't developed at all.
Hey, David!
Good to see you, David!
Hello! Hey. Aw, how are you? Oh, that's a nice smile. Now I'm going to skate with Grant. So it's going to be Shoni and...
Grant.
Yay!
Goodbye.
With David having autism, being able to skate for this charity, it just means so much.
Without you, I like it. Without you, I got no reason. Without you.
beginning. Sinead Kerr and Grant Marshall. We figure the average man on this year's cast is 6'3", 220 pounds. And so, of course, we just assumed the girls would be lifting the guys. Kurt, what did you think?
What's official now? Battle is off. We're on our way.
Yeah.
So are most of your clothes.
Kind of on.
You know what, Sinead, welcome. And you bring talent and strength, obvious strength, and high-octane energy to the show. Good job.
Thank you.
You don't fool me for a second. Standing there with your howdy-doody good looks. No. You're actually a vicious figure skating competitor, and you got weapons. Your feet are weapons. You have footwork, real footwork. You do real figure skating steps. First week, and you have obvious skating confidence. And with that confidence, you allow your cocky, smart aleck attitude to come through. It probably got you in trouble in school when you were a kid. But in Battle of the Blades, it's awesome.
Jamie.
Are you guys always this happy and energetic?
No.
No?
We're always this happy and energetic.
They are.
Yes.
Well,
number's done.
Okay.
That's why.
Well, you obviously have a really natural chemistry. It is so fun and playful. And yes, Kurt is right. That footwork she has you doing is really trippy and difficult. So good for you. Sinead, like, that's just craziness, lifting a hockey player. Any guy.
He's also okay.
I told PJ that we were going to try it after the show, but good for you. That's like superwoman.
Thank you.
PJ.
I don't think there's a better number to start off this year's show. I mean, kudos to both of you. Just the kicky, the high kick, the sliding, the smiling, the facial expressions, which are so hard to do when you're so nervous out there. Yeah. You guys rocked it.
Thank you so much.
Totally magic. Sinead is skating for Autism Speaks, which is helping create a brighter future for those dealing with autism. And Grant's charity is actually the organization's parachute, but Think First is an organization dedicated to preventing brain and spinal cord injury. It's time to get the marks, and we'll begin with Kurt Browning.
Starting high, 5'6".
Jamie Saleh.
I'm the same, 5'6".
PJ Stock.
This might be the only time we're all on par, 5'6".
Terrific start. If you like what you saw from Sinead and Grant, you have to vote for them tonight. It's all being done online this year. Everyone has at least one vote, and you can earn more. For details, go to cbc.ca/battle. Remember, your job is to keep your favorites out of the bottom two and next Sunday's Skate Off. We'll continue. There are seven more pairs coming right up. Battle of the Blades on CBC. Back right after this.